If we want to reverse global warming, it's actually quite easy to do. And we could do it, and we can start today. We could reverse it significantly within 5 years, I believe, that if we had the will and we had enough people that are managing land involved in the process. We're all about life, aren't we? And how we go about living, and are we living a joyful life, or are we living a sad, hateful, fighting sort of life? And a lot of people are living this sad life where they're actually fighting everything around them. And when you're fighting Mother Nature, it is not a war you're ever going to win. Because Mother Nature's got more tricks up her sleeve than we will ever know about. And if we think about that from the point of view of the human race is doing significant damage to this planet, and it's damaging at an accelerating rate. But the planet doesn't actually care, because the planet doesn't need the human race. The human race needs the planet.
To me, the flip side is if we have the power to destabilize the whole planetary system, if we do the right things and the right practices, like regenerative ag, why can't we start pulling that back? Because we know regenerative agriculture can drag down huge amounts of carbon dioxide buried in the soil if we do it right.
So if we're going to change things, we've got to start right back at the farming end of things. And that's what I'd call regenerative. We've got to regenerate the health of our farming systems, our soils. We've got to regenerate that soil microbiome, that plant microbiome, that animal microbiome, which will then regenerate the human microbiome.
There is an innate relationship between hooved animals and quality pasture, because what they do is they take the top off the pasture to allow more sunlight into those pastures, more photosynthesis to take place, which brings the carbon down through the roots of the plant and into our soil profiles. And as grazing animals move across a landscape, particularly when they are moved and paddocks are rested, allows those plants, those plant communities to thrive. That is what produces good carbon in the soil.
Plants and animals have evolved together. And particularly in the rangeland areas, those grasslands don't stay healthy if you try and take the animals off. In fact, the scientist that designed holistic management was an ecologist from South Africa, and he saw the damage that happened when you took the animals out of the system and how it degraded. He realised that it wasn't the animals in the system that were doing the damage, it was how the animals were being managed. In a natural system, the predators bunch the grazing animals together. We take the predators away, now the grazing animals spread out and can do damage. So it's really a case of us trying to mimic that in our management. We want to bunch those animals together. You know, we become the predator, we bunch them together, and then we move them around. And that helps us manage the landscape. So it's a case of whether we're doing things that are degrading the landscape or building the landscape.
Without hooved animals moving across a landscape, eating the tops of our pastures and our landscapes will turn to deserts. That is science, but the message is not getting through.
Carbon is central to this whole linking soil health to human health. Carbon is the foundation of all energy, whether we're talking fossil fuel energy or the energy in the food that you eat. Carbon is the energy source.
We will all benefit from carbon trading. Once we start to sequester carbon in the soil and we end up being reimbursed for it, because once you put an economic value on something, all of a sudden watch things happen. So it will benefit not only farmers in their hip pocket, because it will be income for them down the track. It will sustain them into the future. They'll be carbon farmers.
If it's economic, why aren't we doing it? Why aren't we doing it if it makes investment sense? I can see this being billions and billions of dollars of investment. The urgency is economic. We have a significantly underused economic resource. What's great with agriculture is our land is abundant and is unlimited in terms of the potential for the soil if we look after it. But in addition to that, we're achieving environmental benefits that are significant, and also social impact of actually being able to help farmers on the land. And how great is it? It's food security, it's improving soil health, which is better not only for our planet, but also for our children.
So we've got this beautiful carbon cycle that's been operating now for about 370 million years. It's this amazing bit of technology that Mother Nature developed. And we wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for this carbon cycle. But carbon must cycle. It must go into every living thing, go out of every living thing, and back into every living thing again. The useful place to put it is into soils. What we would be doing is building the health of those soils. So as we put that into the soil, we improve the water holding capacity of the soils. We become more drought resistant. We improve the quality of the food that we produce off those soils, so the consumer's going to benefit from that. We improve the microbiomes because we've now got homes and we've got energy for the soil biology to both attach to and to feed off, and somewhere for their waste products to go. So this is a win-win-win in every direction. We can take CO2 out of the atmosphere, we can put it in a place where it's only going to do good.
Whilst agriculture has contributed to perhaps 12-13% of greenhouse emissions, we are the ones that will be able to sequester carbon. And by sequestering carbon in our landscapes, we can bring these temperatures down. It can be like a second enterprise. Not only can they have their crops and pasture-fed stock, they can also make a living out of sequestering carbon. And Southern Cross University plays a vital role in enabling farmers right across Australia to learn how to do that.